Plus, it's a sound that can cause instant panic the moment you hear. Yeah, it's tough. Well, coming up on Weather Underground. Absolutely. Well, time now for a look at today's weather headlines. Heavy Weather Underground coming up after this. Last week, we had a massive severe weather outbreak, spurning 48 tornadoes, including an EF2. You're seeing it in Silas, Alabama. Of course, you're also looking at all of those tornado reports. Now, the areas hit by that outbreak back in the severe weather threat on Thursday. Could be looking at another potential outbreak. So let's break down the setup and some of the communities that we'll be closely watching here as we move into the end part of the week. We get you into the day Thursday. Here we've got that energy building as our next storm system approaches. That'll provide the lift. Moisture coming in courtesy of the Gulf of Mexico and our southerly winds at the surface. Now, low-level winds turn southwesterly. That helps to support strong thunderstorms and also that possibility of tornadoes. And our strong mid-level winds will also increase that damaging wind threat. So I think you wake up on Thursday to plenty on the radar. Get a little break, though, across parts of Alabama and Mississippi, and that's going to give us enough warmth, enough instability to get those storms really going into the afternoon and evening. Once again, we're looking at storms continuing during the overnight hours. So I think portions of, say, eastern Tennessee, north again, be looking at an overnight threat, that nocturnal possibility. In Jackson, Mississippi, showers out there overnight and into early Thursday. But again, some breaks may give you enough time to see that instability build. You get a few peaks of sunshine, and that could help to fuel some really strong storms during the afternoon and the evening hours. I think beyond, say, 9, 10 o'clock, we're totally done with any rain chances. We look at a place like Birmingham, Alabama. This is a spot that we'll also see, again, a few spotty showers into Thursday morning, but the main action coming as we head into the afternoon. Now, you can see late morning, perhaps some heavy rain showers, but look at 5, 6 o'clock with some storms rolling through, and that continues into the late evening. So timing looks fairly similar to last week, with it being a late evening threat across parts of Alabama, and then again an overnight threat into eastern Tennessee and north Georgia. So widespread severe storms expected across the south. What you need to know, this includes tornadoes, threat of damaging winds, and large hail, and a few strong tornadoes will once again be a possibility out of this week's severe weather danger. And then, Dr. Knapp, you know, you can't really talk about the storms without also talking about ash heavy month when it comes to the weather, right? And then we look at parts of the Northeast where it's wind and rain that you're going to get a good dose in as we head towards the end part of the week. Not to say that we don't have some of those nice days coming, especially in locations like eastern Virginia, southern Maryland, where we're actually going to stay fairly quiet toward the end part of the week. But don't think you escape rain-free. Rain chances are coming to your area as well. This is the Thursday, Friday rainfall total. So again, a lot of interior parts of the Mid-Atlantic and Northeast will get in on that wet weather. We look at the setup on Friday. Our storm system, our first storm system, kind of leaves a stalled out frontal boundary. We know those frontal boundaries serve as a focusing point for shower and thunderstorm development. In this case, it's going to be the rain showers that develop as that moisture gets drawn into the area. And then around the low pressure, gusty winds will develop. So I think we'll be looking at some good wind gusts here as we head into the end part of the week. On Tuesday evening into Wednesday morning, you notice some of those rain showers, quick hitter into the Wednesday early afternoon across parts of the Mid-Atlantic, southern sections of the Northeast, exiting New England as we head into late Wednesday. But now this main event coming in on Thursday, late in the day through the overnight and into Friday. And we'll also be getting in on those gusty winds through that time period. So late Thursday and Friday. We look at our wind gust forecast. Thursday morning starting off pretty quiet, but you can see by later in the day, Mid-Atlantic sections of the south beginning to see some of that that gusty wind activity, including parts of the Ohio Valley in the Midwest. Then we get you into the day Friday, especially the afternoon, just about all of Pennsylvania, northern West Virginia, Maryland, Delaware, even parts of New York State and New York City. Winds gusting 30, even 40 miles an hour in a lot of these locations, Mike.